Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial we'll model this simple block in AutoCAD 3D, and I will provide its file in the description link so you can download it from there and you can practice. And here I will use this drawing as a practice drawing. So let's go to your AutoCAD and let's go to your new, and here I will select this one ACAD, select this one open, and here you can see a new window is opened. So first of all, I will put off these grids, and here you can see that my workspace is 3D modeling, not drafting and annotation. Okay. Also, we are in top view, so I will change it from top view to this one, southeast isometric. Also, I don't want this UCS icon here. Right click, select this one, UCS icon setting, and select this one, show UCS icon and origin. Now I'll go to my drawing, and here you can see that we have a base rectangle 55 by 50 with a extrusion of 10. So let's go to here AutoCAD, and I'll go to here rectangle, and here I'm using default units, and these units are inches. You can use millimeters or whatever. I'm using default units. So select this point, and first I will write 55, then press tab and then 50. And now you can see that a triangle is created, and this dimension would be 50. So I can check this dimension. Let's go to a line command, and here you can see that this dimension is 50. Okay. Let's say I want straight lines. So I will check this one. I will put on this ortho so that I can make straight lines. Let's go to here my drawing, and let's say this extrusion is 10. So let's go to your AutoCAD, and here I can use either extrude command or press pull command. It's better to use press pull command when you are a beginner. So select this one, press pull, and one very important thing when you are using this press pull command is you have to choose this region. Okay, if you are choosing this region, so this press pull command will not work. If you are using inside bounded region or the inside area of the boundary, so this press pull command will work. So I will select this inside region, and I will drag in the upward direction 10 units. Next is we will create this part, and this part is 25 by 25 because this is 50 and this is 25. So 50 minus 25 will give you 25, so this dimension would also be 25. So 25 by 25, and the extrusion is also 25 in the upward z direction. So let's go to here AutoCAD. So let's go to here rectangle, and I will select this vertex, and I will draw one rectangle having dimensions 25 by 25. So press 25, press tab, and then 25, and select enter. Now I will use move command. I will select this vertex, and I will select this vertex. Okay. Now I'll go to here press pull command again, and I'll go inside this bounded region, and I will drag upward 25. And now you can see that this part is also created. Lastly, I will draw this part. So this dimension was 25, and it is 25 minus 5, it is 20, and this dimension is 5. Okay, because I have already extruded 10 units, so it is 5. This extrusion is 5, and this dimension is 20. Okay, and this dimension is let's say 55 minus 25, so this dimension is 30. So let's go to your AutoCAD. So let's change it from wireframe to this one, shades with the edges, and let's select let's say line command, and I will select this vertex. I will draw one line having dimensions 20 units, and then I will join this to this one, and now you can see that we have a closed boundary here, so we can use press pull command. So I will select press pull command, I'll go inside this bounded region, and I will drag in the upward direction 5 units. So here you can see that my part is created, and let's say I can check this dimension is 30. So let's go to your AutoCAD, and let's go to your line command, and let's say this dimension is 30. Okay, you can see that it is 30. I can drag this part, let's select this 3D, and I will drag this to here, and now I can delete unnecessary lines. So that's how you create simple 3D objects in AutoCAD. I hope you like it. And if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.